السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد. My brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the great imams, one of the scholars of the past, he said, إذا أمر الله العبد بأمر, that if Allah orders a person with something, وجب عليه فيه سبع مراتب, then it is obligatory upon him in seven stages. If Allah commands a person with something, then it becomes obligatory upon that person in seven stages. The first, العلم به, having knowledge of that thing, having knowledge of the thing that Allah commanded with. The second, محبته, loving that thing, meaning that the person cannot dislike that which Allah has ordered him with. The third, العزم على الفعل, the third is having the determination to do that deed. The fourth is al-amal, is actually practicing that thing. The fifth, كونه يقع على المشروع خالصا صوابا. The fifth is that the person, the action that the person is doing, it has to be sincere and it has to be correct in accordance to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sixth, التحذير من فعل ما يحبطه, that the person must be aware or cautious from falling into actions that will nullify his deeds. And the last, الثبات عليه, being firm upon that. Today we would like to speak about the first martabah, which is the first level. العلم به, meaning it's an obligation that when the servant is ordered with something, he has to have knowledge of that thing. لا ينبغي للمسلم أن يكون جاهلا. It is not befitting for the Muslim to be ignorant. It is not befitting for the Muslim to be ignorant. يعني in his religion, it is not befitting for the Muslim to be ignorant. Allah Azza wa Jal has ordered us with seeking knowledge. كما قال الله تعالى فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. So Allah, He says, and know. He commands to have knowledge. He commands to seek knowledge. Know that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He distinguishes between people who know and people who do not know. As Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, هَلْ يَسْتَوِ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are the people who have knowledge like the people who do not have knowledge? They are not equal. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was ordered by Allah Azza wa Jal in his statement, وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا, and say, my Lord, increase me in knowledge. And the people of knowledge, they say that Allah did not order his Prophet to ask for an increase in anything except al-ilm, except knowledge. So when we consider the commands that Allah Azza wa Jal has ordered us with in his book, or that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us with in his sunnah, then there are many things. At the head of those things that Allah Azza wa Jalla has ordered us with is at-tawheed, is singling out Allah in worship, and iman, faith, and aqeedah, our belief. The most important thing that we must have knowledge of is monotheism, singling out Allah in worship, iman, our creed, our faith. But we have been commanded with many things: prayer, fasting, zakat, hajj, showing goodness to one's parents, the rights of spouses, the rights that the children have over their parents, the rights that the parents have over their children. There's many things that Allah Azza wa Jal has ordered us with. So we have to ask ourselves, how much time have we put into learning? How much time have we put into learning? When we consider an iman, we consider faith, when we consider our creed, how much do we know about our belief in details? As just the details of our beliefs are mandatory. It is not allowed for the Muslim to be ignorant about his belief system. How much time has he put into learning about his Lord, Rabbul Alameen? How much time has the person put into learning about his prayer, which is the most important aspect of worship after one enters into Islam? It is the most important aspect of worship. How much have we put into learning the prayer? Do we know the differences between the obligations of the prayer, the pillars of the prayer, the recommendations of the prayer? We go through all of these pillars of Islam. How much time have we put into learning the fundamentals of our religion? And the people of knowledge, they say that an ilm, seeking knowledge, is of two types. The seeking knowledge which is an individual obligation, and the seeking knowledge which is a collective obligation. The individual obligation is that knowledge that every single individual must know. He must learn, she must learn. They are in need of that knowledge to worship Allah in their day and their night. This is the Muslim. The Muslim is one who learns his religion. He is one who puts time in learning the fundamentals of his religion. And the second category of knowledge, which is a collective obligation, meaning if some of the Muslims fulfill learning those aspects of knowledge, then the Muslims will not be held responsible as a whole. And also the people of knowledge, they say that it is befitting for the Muslim to take a portion of knowledge or to learn a portion of knowledge every day. Meaning that he does not let one day pass him or her except that they seek knowledge within that day. And the people of knowledge, they have cited the supplication that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would make after Salatul Fajr. Every day after Salatul Fajr, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would say, Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an. O my Lord, I ask you for beneficial knowledge. Wa rizqan tayyiban. And good provisions, وَعَمَلًا مُتَقَبَّلًا, and acceptable deeds. And so the people of knowledge, they say that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he started with knowledge. And he would make this supplication after every Fajr prayer. So this is an indication that you have to seek knowledge every day. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us beneficial knowledge and righteous actions. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وبعد. Also, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the people of knowledge, they also mentioned that in terms of knowledge or having understanding of the religion, it is also of two different types. Meaning that the person must have knowledge of that which Allah has ordered and commanded, as well as having knowledge with that of that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. We must know that which Allah has ordered, and we also must know what He has made haram, those things which are forbidden to do. As the famous narration of Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman radiallahu anhu, he said, كان الناس يسألون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الخير وكنت أسأله عن الشر مخافة يدركني. He said that the people used to ask the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم about the good, and I used to ask him about the evil, fearing that it will reach me. And also the people of knowledge, they say, how can a person protect himself from something that he does not know? How can a person protect himself from something he does not know? So just as we are obligated to know Tawheed, monotheism, Iman, faith, we are also obligated to know its opposite, ash-shirk, polytheism, kufr, disbelief. Just like we must know Sunnah, in order for us to follow the Sunnah, we must also know al-bid'ah, we must know innovation. Just as we must know obedience to Allah, we also must know what is disobedience. And all of these matters require time. It requires us to put efforts into learning about the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the one who learns that which is forbidden, he learns it in order to avoid it. So from those things that the people of knowledge have mentioned, like you study aqidah, you study belief, you study books of tawheed, but you also study things like things would nullify your Islam. We are Muslim, we also must learn that which will make us non-Muslim. You are a believer, you also must know what would make you a kafir, a disbeliever. You're obedient to Allah, you must also learn what would make you fall into disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah to make us from those who have beneficial knowledge and righteous actions. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal for a good ending. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa aqim as-salah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح.